Hey guys, Welsknight here, and welcome back to another episode of Kingdoms. In today's episode, we're going to be doing some work over here in Solus, working on the cathedral a bit more. We're coming up on episode 100. I think this is episode 93 now or something like that. And I really want to get this cathedral completely finished before the episode 100 world download, as well as some other projects that we're kind of working on too. So that is definitely something that I want to work on today. And we did have a live stream, and during the live stream, I finished up these towers right here. So those are in good shape. And that's this tower and then the one on the far side over there. I also did some work over here. I decided to get rid of these buttresses. I think on this scale, they're just not going to look good. I tried reworking them and some stuff and different things, and I just couldn't get them to look the way I wanted to. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to go without them, and we'll put some stained glass windows or something like that in these chunks to add detail. Now, there's also the tower way up there, and that is going to be a bit of a challenge, especially on this side, because we've got a lot of space up there to fill and make interesting. And then we also have these little bits right here too. So this thing is also going to have to be all decked out. And of course, then we still need to do the interior of the cathedral, which is also going to take a significant amount of time. So there's still a lot of work left to do on this cathedral in order for it to look, you know, good. So I think the first thing I want to do is I want to carve out some spots for stained glass windows. I think that's probably the logical first step. We can kind of figure out where we want those to go. And I'm thinking, let's see. Oh, is this an even number? No, it's not. Okay, good. So I'm thinking we're going to have like three wide windows right here. And those will go up, Maybe even all the way up to there? Yeah. Alright, so we'll bring them up that high. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so 6 high total. So there'll be like 3x6 windows. There we go. And we'll carve those out and have some sort of big decorative stained glass window right there. And then I think we're going to want to do the same thing on the other side too. So let's kind of swing over to here. Ooh, that's, you know what? We can just do, oh, that was a terrible jump. Try again. There we go. And let's just bring those up like so. Now, as far as the stained glass windows go, I would like to use glass blocks and kind of shape these windows. Ooh, I missed a little bit up here. Kind of shape these windows into sort of this, like, arch. I'd like an arch window here. I think that would be best. But the only way that I'm going to be able to do glass blocks here and make this look decent is if we shrink this all the way down to, like, 3 wide. Because I would need the glass blocks on this layer and then another wall on this layer, and that's just not going to look good. So I think what I may do is I may find some other way to kind of create that illusion. Or I suppose it wouldn't be... Actually, I may have another way we could make this work, possibly. It wouldn't look as good, but I think we can still pull it off. First and foremost, though, I'm lost in my house. There we go. First and foremost, I think what we should probably do is let's grab some stone out of here and let me just make some stone bricks and let's make some stone brick stairs. There we go. Because what I'm thinking is windows that are shaped something along those lines, right? So we have kind of this arch shape. I think that fits a lot better. Let's see how that looks from over here. Yeah. That's good. That's definitely good. So I like that. Now, the hard part here is going to be getting the glass blocks in and making those look good. But I think we have some ways we might be able to pull that off. I really wish that glass panes would be able to connect to stairs in a way that actually looks halfway decent. However, they don't. So, that's okay. But anyway, let's punch those out, and then let's go ahead and let me get a few more of these windows, like, over here, and some of that kind of stuff as well, and then I'll come back to ya. Alright guys, I am back, and I've got all the stained glass windows in. I've decided to go with just a real simple design like this, kind of to, simulate or represent, like, a rising sun. So you have the sun down here, and then a little bit of brightness, and then the sky up above. That's kind of what that's supposed to represent, and it's really just about the getting those colors in there. It's very hard to work in a lot of detail with a three-wide design like that, so I may change that up later, but for now I just kind of want to get these windows in, and I can tweak them at a later time if I want to. Now, another thing, lessons learned, if I had to rebuild this whole cathedral, I would bring this out wider. Because what's going to happen is I'm going to have to fill this part in right here. And that's going to leave me with only three wide right here. And I'd really prefer for that to be a lot wider. Because it's not going to feel right with something that's supposed to be big and grand like this cathedral. I may end up walling these off, in fact. And just making it so that when you come in, these wings are maybe like side rooms of some sort, so we'd actually have like a wall, you know, right here. And then you would go through some sort of a door to get back to these other chambers, or these other portions of the cathedral. And that way it doesn't feel quite as bad. I'm not really a fan, but sometimes you gotta make do with what you got. And at this point, given that this is survival, yeah, I'm not rebuilding this whole thing. It's not happening. So we're going to have to make do with what we got. But I think the next step is probably to bring this part out so this wall lines up. And then what we'll do here is we'll get our windows in like this. Because when it comes to building, like, A, I'm not really that great at interiors anyway. But I'm generally far more concerned with how something looks on the outside than on the inside. And we can still work with this space and do things so that this doesn't look quite so bad. Like, I might be able to add in some stairs here, for example, and that'll still make it feel like it's five wide because they're not taking up a full block and they recess, but then it will also create that depth, and we can maybe put pillars of some sort here so that basically you've got like a three wide walkway, but it'll feel bigger than that because we'll have all this open space here. So that's kind of what I'm planning. Yeah, but anyway, next step, definitely get these walls filled in over here and here, and then get the border around these windows all ready to go.
We'll be right back.
Alright guys, I am back, and I hope you enjoyed that little time lapse there. So, we got the windows in place. I don't think I'm going to be able to do this extra detail over here. I don't think I'm going to be able to do that in these side rooms. We'd have a one wide walkway, and that would not look good. Now, I want to take a look. I haven't actually looked at these windows from the outside, but I think they'll still look good. Yeah, they still look good from the outside with that little stair there. So I think that's fine. Okay, so now we need to do a couple other things. I want to do something up here to kind of dress that up a bit. And then also I want to do probably something along here. Probably close these off. I don't know if I want to close them off at this level. Ooh, that was almost a fall down. Actually, I need to get down underneath the cathedral and light some stuff up. But why don't we... I'm kind of thinking... Let's grab some of this stone here. I'm kind of thinking I want to close these off, like right here. And then we'll have a doorway. And then basically what's going to happen is we'll have just a wall like this, and then this will be a doorway that goes in, and then we'll have some detail added to this section, and same on the other side as well. So let's just kind of get that stuff in place. There we go. That looks pretty good, and that gives us kind of this nice big open circular feel to the room, which is good, because as you're walking here, it opens up, and that's always a good feeling. So then up there, we're going to have to add some detail. Let me grab some stone slabs and some diorite. And actually, let's grab some stone bricks as well. There we go. And let's try and work our way up to about there should be good. So I think what I want to do is I want to cover up this birch back here. I don't really care for that. I don't like the way that that looks. So what I'm thinking is we'll do something like this. We'll make like little cross beams right here. And then we'll fill those in with diorite, and you won't be able to see the birch then. And then what we can do is take some stairs like so. I'm gonna have to bring this over one so I can get there and there. And then same thing on that side there. And there. Okay, so that should do. And then this area up here we'll just fill in with smooth stone or something. We'll probably end up putting like a proper ceiling up here of some sort. I don't know what yet, but just something to kind of cover up some of that mess, I guess. All right, let's come back down and take a peek. Let's see how that looks. That looks pretty good. It emphasizes those arches, which I think is good. I'm not really a huge fan of the fact that the stone brick is lighter than the diorite, but there's not really a whole lot we can do about that because diorite doesn't come in stairs. So we're just going to kind of have to make do with what we got. And you know what? That's fine. Now here, I'm kind of thinking... I don't know what I want to do with this room yet. I know we need to do something with this room. Probably add a pillar of some sort right here. Like so. And on this side as well. Gotta go up a little higher. There we go. So we do maybe something like that, and then maybe we'll have another pillar here. I don't really know yet. Haven't really decided. Let's run and take a sleep real quick. Sleep time. There we go. All right. So that's good, I think. That's good to go. Now, I think the next thing that I want to hold off on working on the interior of the church too much more, but I think we do need to see about adding some depth and some detail and interest to those outside walls. So let's grab some more stone brick slabs and a bit more diorite here. I'm actually running fairly low on diorite. I do have a lot here that's unpolished, which is good, because I can polish that up. But at the same time, we are running a bit low. Our stores are depleted a bit. And then I don't know yet what I want to do with those rooms. We do have spawnable areas up there, though, which is something we need to be kind of careful of. We're going to have to light those up at some point, but I'm not going to worry about it right this very moment. So, as far as this goes, we could add a two-wide pillar here, but then it's going to look super off-center. So I don't think that's what we want to do. Maybe instead we do something like this right here. And then something similar here. Right? Just to kind of create that effect. Now, I'd like to work some birch fences in, which will be a lot easier to do here than over here, I think. Let me go grab some. We're probably going to want those. If I'm going to work birch. Wow, words. Why are words so difficult? If I'm going to work birch fences, there we go, into the design, I should probably have some with me. Just a thought. Anyway, so let's go. And I kind of like these designs to match. Like, I'd like them to seem like they go together. So maybe what we'll do is we'll put some birch fences in the corners like that. Grab that one back. And then let's go up a little bit more. Then maybe like here, 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 here. Just kind of emphasize those lines. We can put a birch fence there and there. And maybe one like hanging. Hell no, I don't want that to hang down in the middle. Because I can't make it hang down in the middle and be symmetrical on the other side. So maybe we'll do something. Ah, man. Falling. There we go. Maybe we'll do something like this. And there. That might do the trick. Let's see how that looks. I have a feeling that's going to look pretty good. Let's just take a peek. From a distance. Yeah, that looks all right. That looks pretty good. I like this effect. You get that nice shadow. You get the little lighting changes there, and those look pretty good. I'm not a huge fan of this big kind of middle chunk here, but I don't think we really have much of a choice, to be honest. Just because over here, it's not going to look... I don't think there's really a whole lot we can do about it if we want those designs to kind of match up. So we're just going to have to live with it. Let's do... Oh, I can't reach that, can I? Nope, of course not. Let's just make ourselves a little scaffolding platform type deal here. There we go. And then we're going to want birch fences going up like so. And like so. And then this is going to kind of come up and down and up and down. Okay. And then up here, we'll put a couple of those. I think I'm going to change this one up a little bit because that lighting, it's not doing it for me. I'm not a fan of that. But I think this could work. Maybe. Possibly. I think that'll work. Let's take a look. Let's just kind of bring our way down. Let's take a look at that from over here. It looks all right, but this is not good right here. We need to do something with this. I might have an idea. Maybe what we can do here is something like this. Maybe that'll do. Like, it'll just kind of create this extra shape there, but the problem is it's that stone brick, and that does not look as good. I wish it was the diorite, but diorite doesn't come in stairs. Hashtag blame Mojang. Because I think that would actually look pretty good if it came in stairs, but it doesn't. So, I don't know. That really doesn't stand out at all. And it looks out of place because the block palette for everything else for this exterior detail is all either stone slab or diorite. And in this case, it's just not there. So if you have ideas for what we could do right here to kind of make that look a little bit more interesting, I mean, I don't think it looks horrendous. I don't think it's like bad. But I also don't think it looks amazing either. So let me know if you have ideas for what we can do right there to kind of dress that up a little bit. Let me go ahead and get this done to the other side over there, and then I'll come back to you. All right, guys, I am back, and I think that looks pretty good. Like, that's not terrible. I think it's good. So I got the other side all finished up, as you may have guessed from the fact that I was just talking about it. We still need to kind of clean up these little interior bits up there. We still got to figure out what we're going to do for these rooms. Also, there's a zombie way up there. I see him. And we should probably light up those upper areas, but I'm not going to worry about that right now, which I will probably come to regret later when a creeper falls down and blows up half the structure. But I think this looks really good, and I really like this kind of nice effect. Like, if you stand back and you kind of cross your eyes a little bit to make it a little bit blurry in your eyesight, it really kind of creates this nice, like, layered effect. It looks like more layers than it actually is because of the shadows that these little bits right here kind of create. So I think that's really cool. I like it. Still have a ton of work left to do with this cathedral. Tons of it. Let's take a little bit of a sleep real quick, and we'll see what we can do. Also, guys, so I got a new camera, actually. Wifey and I did a New Year's vlog, which some of you may have seen, and it was super fun, and we had a blast, and Wifey enjoyed it so much, Mrs. Wells enjoyed it so much, that we've decided to start doing vlogs more regularly, and so I went and I finally got a decent camera. It's been something that I've just been putting off forever and ever and ever. The best camera that I owned up to this point was like a little one of those like $100 Nikon point and shoot cameras, you know, that's not really that good at all. It's good for like taking a quick snapshot to put on Facebook, but it's really not a good camera. So Wifey and I decided, you know, as we grow older, see, I told you I was going to regret not lighting those upper areas up. just my luck. All right, tell you what, let's get some torches and let's fix that right now. Pretty sure I have all the stuff I need in here. Maybe I don't have any coal with me. I mean, I could make charcoal, but that's a pain. Let's see if I have any hanging out over here. No coal here. Do I have any hiding in this chest? No. Really? I don't have, like, any coal? Is there any in the... Aha! Coal in the furnaces. Always a good place to check. There we go. All right, so now we have some torches, and we can light those areas up so that stuff stops spawning up there and trying to kill me. But what was I talking about? Oh, yes. So Wifey and I decided that, you know, as we get older, we really should have some way to kind of capture our memories and our moments and stuff like that together. So I finally decided to spring for a decent camera. I got a Nikon, or I'm sorry, I got a Canon 80D. It's basically a DSLR camera. I would call it like a semi-professional kind of mid-range DSLR. Certainly nothing incredibly awesome, but definitely good enough for what I want to use it for. And it's really kind of a video-focused camera as well. I'm more, to be honest, when it comes to cameras, I'm far more of a Nikon fan. That's what my family has used. My dad, my mom and dad, as I was growing up and stuff. I've always been a Nikon fan more than anything else. But I couldn't find anything that was really kind of a video-focused camera in Nikon's product lineup that was within my budget and had the features that I wanted and stuff like that. So I ended up going with Canon 80D. You should be seeing, if all goes according to plan anyway, you should be seeing a vlog today recorded with that DSLR. And I think it's going to be a lot of fun. And you're going to see a lot more vlogs on the channel, I think, which is also good. I'm certainly not going to do like the whole daily vlogger thing or anything like that. Like, that's, I think that's a bit excessive, especially for a gaming channel. But I think it would be cool to do, like, you know, maybe once a week a vlog or something like that. Maybe one video a week is a vlog on, you know, one day of the week. Just kind of like a, sometimes like a weekly recap or, you know, videos that have wifey in it or hi, zombie. Bye, zombie. Or any of that kind of stuff. I think it would be fun. So we're going to try that out. I'm also going to try out some new things with editing in regards to those vlogs as well, and different stuff. I'm going to take a lot of inspiration from some of the people that I watch and enjoy. I'm just going to put these up here for the moment, and maybe here and here to kind of light those upper areas up. Those torches will go away eventually once we have a bit more space, or once this is a little bit closer to completion. But I think we're probably okay for now, just putting some torches there to keep nasty things from spawning up here and trying to kill me. There we go. That should be good. All right, let's take a peek at that. That seems to all be filled in. These I fixed and lit up. Those I lit up. I did that side as well, and this side, there's no spawnable. Ooh, there are spawnable areas. Good thing I double-checked. Okay. See, this is why you double-check things, my friends, because half the time you miss stuff, and you don't even realize it until it's too late and a creeper falls on your head. There we go. All right, that should be good. So, we actually got a pretty fair amount done today on the cathedral. We got all these windows in place. We came up with the kind of window design pattern, and I think we're making some really good progress on this thing. But unfortunately, guys, I'm out of time for this episode. So my friends, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check it out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.